Recent asymmetric warfare and their in their in enforcing counter in insurgency warfare methods also. And recently the Indian Army released in December 2018 the land warfare doctrine. In that they emphasize more on these how to tackle these unconventional warfares and how better we are prepared and how we can deter Pakistan from indulging in these attacks. And the second thing is, as you all be the future stakeholders, like you will be the politicians, you will be the executives, there needs to be confidence building measures to be taken. Because unless and until there is no confidence among the people that these army people are helping us and not against us, then there cannot be a real development in Kashmir. This is so because the people are the informants for the militants over there. They can give tip to the terrorists over there, and they can make one of the most successful military operation into failure. Unless and until there is some agreement between the localites and the government, and there is some development programs taken by the government to help them feel that yes, Indian Army is with them and not against them, until then there is no permanent solution to the Kashmir issue. Now, the role of students towards nation building. See, as you all know, we are having a demographic dividend. You know what demographic dividend is? In a simple terms, it is profits from the working population. See, we are all youngsters, and our country will by 2030, our average national age will be around 29. So we'll be having an edge over other holding economies such as US, China, Japan, because their demography will be full of aging people. So this is the advantage we have. And the most ironic and paradoxical thing is that it can be a disadvantage. Because unless we focus on preparing our future youths into, like, most of the future youths are concentrated in the rural areas. Unless we give them some skill developments and we give them quality primary education, demographic dividend would be of no use. Because you cannot expect development through uneducated people. And the thing is, we Indians tend to focus more on statistics and quantity rather than quality. This approach is a trickle-down approach. To give you an example, suppose you consider a water being poured to soil continuously, and after some time it reaches the underground basin, underground water basin. This is a trickle-down approach, and the same approach is used in economies, where they focus more on the top end spectrum of the working population. They create more growth and more job opportunities in the top sector, thinking that after some time it reaches the lower strata of society and brings down poverty. But this is a failure in India, because that is not happening. We must concentrate more. For example, think about the primary schools you might have seen. Everywhere we see government run primary schools, but the thing is, we don't have quality. We are focusing much on quantity. This is not a healthy sign. And the second thing is the threat of brain drain. Let me ask you, how are you planning to do your MS in abroad? Please raise your hands. Are you being truthful to yourself? You are not planning to go to abroad? Because see, going to abroad is not an issue, but not returning back is the issue. You would have gained so much knowledge, so much academic knowledge, and if you use the there is so much human capital being sent to the other countries that our India, the brain drain is happening in our country. This is the major issue we are facing. Perhaps you can go for MS in US and get settled for few years, but the reverse brain drain must happen. This is when this is when you can pay back something to the society. This is when you can be a patriot. This is how you can be a patriot. So, and as engineers, we have various avenues where we can be patriots. For example, recently DRDO released a new Dare to Dream challenge. In that, they are asking for people to come up with ideas based on advanced issues like artificial intelligence, smart materials, hypersonic technologies, and they want youngsters to contribute to the well-being of the nation. Being patriot doesn't mean joining defense services and giving up your life for the country. Being patriotism is doing things at the right time, at the right age. Suppose you're pursuing engineering for 4 years and you end up having backlogs and you spend another year focusing on skill development, then you're not being patriotic because you're reducing 1 year of the demographic dividend advantage to our country. You are not utilizing your time in an effective manner, and you're not utilizing the human capital in you to bring the best out of you in the required time. This is the most patriotic thing you can do, is to focus on what you're doing right now, in what you're doing, what you're studying. Do it in a better and more productive way. That is the best thing you can do as a patriot. And apart from that, you can actually see, some of us don't find the connection between our engineering studies and the national interest. Actually, they are directly linked, because whenever you excel in something, you actually contribute something to the nation. Okay, for example, if you are interested in aerodynamics, I mean aerospace and all, you concentrate during your engineering studies on those topics. Like, try to build on a new, try to create inventions, try to be creative, so that after a few years you can go work in our reputed institutions such as DRDOs, ISROs, and contribute something to the country. And being patriotic has dual responsibility, one towards the country and other towards the countrymen. Until you help the people who are downtrodden, who are poor, you don't contribute much to the country, because a nation is not made up of ideas such as nationalism, patriotism and things like that. The nation is made up of its people. Even the most poor of Indians, poor of our people are Indians. We need to contribute something towards them and make their life more meaningful. And the second thing is, have a sense of nationalism. One, owe it to the country, because we all owe our lives to our country. We all owe our education, our food, everything to our country. So we are the face of the new Naya Bharat. See, we make up new India, because 20 years from now we'll be holding various positions in different sectors, and we'll be the face of the new country. And if we indulge ourselves in apathy and not working, like if we postpone our work, then it is no use, because we need to take because the helm of the affairs will be in our hands. So I say that our Intifada should be against our terrorism, corruption and social ills, and our Fidayeen should be towards innovation, creativity and nation building. We are the makers of our nation's destiny. So let's pledge ourselves to make for a better country and for a Naya Bharat. And I like to end with the quotes of J.F. Kennedy. Ask not what the country can provide for you, but rather ask what you can do for your country. Thank you.
Bharat, as a moment of appreciation, we would like to present this pen to you. Thank you everyone for taking out few minutes of your time, because our soldiers at the borders are keeping their lives at stake, and so that we can live this moment right now. So thank you so much, within the sun and because of this hot weather, you're still over here, gathering over here to offer our condolences and awaken the patriotism in us. Thank you.